Hello and very warm welcome to all of you to this webinar about source control for Microsoft Dynamics NV with CAL objects. My name is Jesper Kenborg, I'm your presenter today. I have worked with NV since 1991 and also for example been developing on the multi-currency and euro functionality in Microsoft headquarters for the worldwide version. In 2015, I incorporated Tools for AP to focus on products that can make everybody's life easier working with NAV and Business Central. So again, a warm welcome to everybody who's joined us today. I'm very happy to be able to present this product to you. A little bit about the company history, and then we'll move into the source control demo, and that will be the focus, of course, today. So very short on PowerPoint, and then to the real stuff. Should you have any questions on the way, feel free to ask. I will keep the question board open, and if I can answer on the way, of course I will do that. Else I will catch up at the very end. There will be a QA session as well at that point of time. Okay, so let's get started. Source control. What's the benefit and why should you have any kind of source control? Even if you say CL is not the latest, it is an old technology, you can say, but anyway, it's still not too late to catch up on that. There's still projects and customers out there which really need a good solution. And for that reason, we decided to develop this tool, which should be really fast and efficient. And as you know, the pain points today, you have no tracking today of in standard NAV or Business Central of any changes in CL. You have no options to make any code compare for that same reason, and you have no version control, no quality control, no central and shared access for everybody. You need to be able to look into the objects to see what is going on. And of course, there are some alternative solutions in the market, we are aware of that, but those solutions are usually quite complicated to deploy, complex to use and understand, and also very expensive. So we thought there must be a good alternative solution, and that is what we have made ready for you in our toolbox source control. And the key benefits which you can enjoy from this solution is that you will be able to get this whole thing up and running in 5 minutes, at least the installation, and no additional NAV or BSC license is required, so you don't need to configure anything for yourself or for your clients. No additional objects need to be installed. It's a cloud-based solution, so you can connect from anywhere in the world and set up connections between locations with no limits. And you can track all changes of all objects, obviously, and you have a history of all changes, also a history of versions, and as a really nice benefit here, I can also inform you, you will also be able to compare any object with a Microsoft standard object. It means also when you start with the solution, immediately you will be able to create the first version of all changes, means it will detect what changes you have in your current solution. And we also have a smart health check, which will check you have created, for example, documentation, version numbering, stuff like that. And a release management. How about the architecture? How does it work? Well, we have based everything on Azure, where everything will be based on a snapshot stored in SQL database. And we call that snapshot actually stored in a what you call object analyzer in our toolbox. And then you will be able to connect with that from a local connector, your source control connector, which run as a Windows service on any Windows computer, local computer, Windows XP, Windows Server, anything. And that one will use FinSQL to connect to your local NAV or BC database. How about security? Well, we've decided to have a really high focus on that. So to make sure we have safety first, and obviously nobody can access your data at all. On top of that, we have your cloud hosting security, the app security. And finally, for login and token, we have decided to use Auth0. What's required to get started? Well, 6 simple steps. You first create an account on Object Analyzer if you don't have that already. Then you create a snapshot. with source control. Then you download the connector. You run the connector on the PC or server where you want to install it. And of course, that must have access to your NAV or VC database. That's the only requirement. And you select the snapshot you want to connect to. And you start the service. That's it. Very simple and very easy and should be without any complications. So what we'll do now, we'll try to run through this, set up from scratch, track up the first changes, do some code compare, quality and version control, and finally also do what we call a stage compare, where you can compare different stages. It could, for example, be development in live or live prod or test in live, what you prefer. Good. So what you first can do is you can go to nowtoolbox.com. That's the first thing. After that, what you do, you can click on source control. You can, of course, read about the product information, source control, but you can also jump straight to the getting started. And here you will have the step guide available online. You can also see a short video about how to get it up running in 5 minutes if you prefer that. But the first thing you have to do, create a user. I have already done that, so I'll skip that step. Then you need to download the connector. Basically, you click here and you just download. That's it. And store it where you want, unzip the file package, and then I will jump in to show you after unzipping what will happen. So you can see here, I have now my folder available here, which I have unzipped, and inside that folder, you can see I have played a little bit around here with some different versions. Here you have the connector, and what I do, I just run the connector. And if you already have logged in, as I did in this case, you can see you will have your login account. Next thing, I can just go one step back. I can stop and uninstall. That will be how it will look like for you. So after you've logged in, you will just see the snapshot. You can refresh, see what snapshot you have. You can click create, and you will then be redirected to Object Analyzer's snapshot creation page. You can then select a client if you want to. It's up to you if you want to categorize the snapshots somehow. Else you select the product version. It could, for example, be a 17. You select the country version. You could be a French, for example. You give it a name. Test in a webinar. Something XXX, like that. And you can select availability. Should it be available to everybody, a group, or only a specific user? You can, of course, have a creation date here. You can specify a version. I can call this my live and my first snapshot with source control, right? Oops, with something, yeah, whatever. And you see below here, it says automatically update snapshot, include health check. I can play around and decide if I automatically want to have this update or not. Last thing I need to decide is for my date and time format. And I need to decide that because when the objects are exported in text format, if they don't have the format which the source control and snapshot will understand, it will not match. So how do you know? Well, usually you can, of course, select and see your date and time on your computer. But if you're running on the server, actually the export will use the server settings. So what you can do, you can look inside your connector on the top. We will display the server settings. And as you can see on my computer, I have date, month, year. But actually here, the server has month slash date slash year. And the time format is also 12 hours format on the server. So you select that here in the option field. What is your date and time format? You just select it here, what you have, 12 hours, for example, like that. And click create. When I've done that, I just can try to do that here, create. That's fine. I now have created my first snapshot. If I now go back to my connector, I click refresh. And now I will see the test in webinar just created right now is available right here. I will now select my database. And I believe you know maybe even better than I do. Not that I don't know, but of course you can go to your, for example, your development environment information, and then you can pick up your server information, database information from here. And you just copy and paste it back into the fields here. Next thing is the file path. There's also several ways to find that. You can of course just browse your way through, or you can right click here and pick it from properties inside the program. When you've done that as well, you can decide if you want to use license swapping. What is that for? Well, if your client also need to have it installed and you want to monitor what has been installed on the client and they don't have access to the export objects in text format, you can do a silent in the background license swapping here by just activating here and select your own license file which you want to use for just the export. It will then be used, exported, and silently swap back again after the export has been completed. And of course, when you do that, you need to select if it's like your server or your database where the license is installed. Finally, you need to select it's active. You should also select if it's this computer, it will automatically pick up the name and how often you want the export to happen. If you're in development environment, maybe you want to run it every minute, but for example, it could be on your client, you just want to run it once daily, for example. When all is set and done, you click save and then you can click on the install and you can click start and it will automatically run all now which are active on this computer. And I can see this computer, I have 1, 2, 3, and this one is right now active. And I can see that it is only updating hourly. Maybe that's not so good for the demo purpose. So what I will do is I will just change that to say that I want to update every minute. I click save. And I will be able to see here when should the next update happen. And it will also tell me that to make this change take effect, I will have to restart the scheduler. So that is done now. All good. So I will now jump into the product chain where I can now start to see my source control. So I will go here and select tools. Here and my source control, and I have, oh, that was this one here, selected from here. Good, tools, that's it. And I have my live environment running right here. And I will be able to see my source control management. It is active, I can see it's running every minute. And I can see when was the last update. Last pulse, it will tell me here when was the last pulse. So right now it says 16 minutes ago. So let's see if it's now is running. So it says here every minute and this one should be running. Let's see if I'm on the same one. Live production should be this snapshot. Yeah, live. This should be the one. So let me just restart this one just to make sure that it is now taking effect. I will go back to my snapshot here. And now you can see it's been updated a few seconds ago before. Now it says 1 minute ago. So my source control is now running. So what I can do now is I can go to my development environment. I can look for any object. For example, I have an object here which called this page copy text setup. So what I will do is I will go into this object. I will change something. Let's say this field, they don't want this caption. They want to say groups active. They want to say not activated. That's a request they want. They also want to add some code. So I will go to the code setup, coding. And start to play a little bit around. So let's say they want to change this from true to false. And I don't do any documentation. Here I will add one more line of code. Here. First change. Like that. I will save my object. That's it. And of course now, depending of how you can say lucky or unlucky I am according to the time, is it running every once a minute right now? Of course, I will have to make sure it get updated and exported from here. And as the next thing, I will also have to see that it get updated back into my online solution. So let's give it just a few seconds here to update. If anybody have any questions, please feel free to write. And this is a good time just to use this few seconds to maybe raise a question. As we wait for this update, I will go back and also check my online solution, see here when will it read. It says here a few seconds ago, so it looks like now it has been updated. So if I now go down, the next thing of course is my browser also need to be updated. So I'll just refresh that, else it will automatically refresh every once a second. So I'll go to my changes and see that right now today at 14:17, I did make a change to the page 476, and I go back and check. This was the page 476. It's correct. So I now want to know what was changed. If I want to know that, well, I will check inside here, and I can see I have made some changes. I have set from activated, I have changed that code also to not activated. I have made a message here as well, and I also have set here this true to false. So three things was made, and if I want to, I can also scroll further down and see what was this compared to the previous version of this object. So now I'll be able to see what is all the changes to my previous release. So everything I have changed so far now is all what has been listed here. I can also see compared to the snapshot or to a complete standard object. So here I will now see everything has been changed from day one on this object compared to, for example, this Hello Sarah apparently has been set in. Has been changed something here from group just to not activated. That was the total change. So apparently somebody has first asked to add the activated. So now I know from the base what is all the changes that's been made to this. And some documentation here. Okay, that was the first thing I can do. What more can I do? Well, I can do a lot of things. Let's go back and have a look. I of course have a summary by date where I can see how many changes has been done date by date if I want to monitor and track the progress. So I can see by type, number of objects, or by change type. And I can also go down to the version here. And let's say I want to monitor a version. I can now sort here, for example. So I can see, for example, this object have three versions. So if I want to check that, I can now see that actually here in the version list, apparently there's been, since I started the source control, I started on version 13, which was in Jan. Then in February, I released a version 14, and in March, 16. For some reason, somebody decided to skip 15, apparently. And I can see for all of them, there's been code changes. I can also see there's been documentation changes. So if I now want to know what was actually done in, for example, the last release, I can click here and I can see all the changes to the last release. So here apparently some insert of some new fields on that page. And if I want to know what is the documentation, I can read the specific documentations that was added for this one. Undocumented changes, so it's just an example that you will be able to see exactly what comments was added on that change. If I want this object for some reason, let's say I want to restore the previous version, I can always just click here on the download button and I'll be able to get all the versions here now. So the base version, previous change, previous version, the source, and the standard object at any point of time. I also have the health check, so I will be able to see here if this right now have a healthy state. For example, the top one says no, it don't. Why not? Well, or the second one, let's take that one again. It says here, well, you have updated the code, but in this case, there's not been updated any documentation yet. So for the next release, somebody have made some code, and if I want to know exactly what was the code change, apparently this two fields was removed. not documented. So now I can go back, add my documentation, and then this one will be black again as it should be. When it says yes and red in this case, it means I have made documentation, but somebody have modified the code after the last documentation. So it may or may not be correct. I will have to check that. And again, it just has some updates here for the sample, but I can check that. When I'm ahead of stage and create a new release, it will be green, as you will see an example here. I have some which have healthy states here, I think. Oh, maybe not at this point of time, but some of them will, of course, have a healthy state when I have made my customizations. So also to take note here that when you start, you will have your first version of all customized objects. You will also be able to determine straight away the current CO level of an object. So this one, for example, have CO level, the job module, a job table, have CO level 5, and there's 6 updates available for Microsoft. So if I click here, I will be able to see what updates are available, not yet installed. So if I have a problem, I can actually check for Microsoft, have made any fix for that. And again, if I want to compare that, I can compare that change. For example, it could be something about here with an error message displaying blah, blah, blah. Yeah, the customer have that. And if I want to see what Microsoft changed, I'll be able to see the checked change straight away here. So they added this line and modified that line and added some more lines here. So if I need, I could actually manually deploy that change if it don't impact anything else, of course. All right. There was a quick look at that. Let's have one more example here. What you can do, you can set up stages. So under the administration here on the snapshot, you can decide to set up a number of stages. In this case, you can see I've set up 2 stages. So I have stage 1, which is my development. I just call it live here, it doesn't actually really matter, just an example. And then I have another one, which is my production. You could create up to unlimited number of different stages here. And if you just want to compare, so you can see right now I have my one live here with my development and my prod. So if I want to compare, I can compare with the current stage, or I could also decide to compare all to get an overview what is actually going on. I want to have the full picture, what is in development, not in tests, in test, not in live. So now we'll get this compare below. And by default, it shows all objects. Well, that's not too interesting for me. I want to know any step difference, means there's something strange on one of the steps. So I can see here now, based on the icons here on top, for example, the blue one indicates that this object has been updated and needs to be moved to next stage. So in development, apparently, those objects here, all listed here, need to be moved to the production. And also you can see if an object, for example, the red one here means that object, yeah, it needs to be updated, but it's actually missing. And we also have that as a clear specification that now this object is actually missing in my production. I look at it as a small view. I can select large view. I can filter if I just want to look at my tables, for example, by type. So I can say I just want to look at that or look at reports, see if there are any. There was not. But if I want to take tables, for example, I can just focus on my tables if I want to get them, for example, updated first. What's the status on them? If I want to, I can actually also here now select I want to copy this one. So I want this index. It already create the index filter for me. I select copy, I go back, I go to my tables, and I press, they make a filter, and straight away it has created the filter, so I can mark those objects, export them, and transfer them to my development, or my live, in this case, environment. A lot of features, a lot of small, nice features that will save you a lot of time, and most importantly, keep track of all changes at all time and is so easy to get started. So yeah, back to this one. So set up from scratch, I showed you that, tracking of changes. I showed you code compare and the quality also where you can check off changes and documentation and version control. I have showed also at the very end, compare the development versus live. So How to really get started? What can you do? Well, before you do that, I can inform you, for example, some of our customers, for example, here, Peter has decided to give us a very good statement that this was a wonderful program, a tool, he loved it. So hopefully that also could bring value to other partners and customers out there. So why? Well, we have support, you have quick overview about Enough Analyzer. You also have other features. We have support tool, we have overview, we have analyzing of add-on modules. So if you want to do upgrade, you can easily create proposals. You can actually also perform CU update with a one-click solution. We have version upgrade, we have tracking of unknown object changes. We have also tracking of data changes. So a lot of other things is also available in Object Analyzer, which I could not show you today because of the limited time. So to get started, well, we have this price model. You can start with Essential, basically pay as you go, no charge, or only for you pay for those features you decide to activate. You can have a basic subscription with the listed features here available. The next one here is how to get started. Really, you have also the option just to start with a trial, so there's no pay. You have 2 weeks just to try it out. All the features, unlimited access, unlimited users. And for example, a price example here, if you're just a one person wants to use the source control, well, it's $59 per month. Unlimited number of changes. Or if you are a group of users, for example, 2 to 5, you can have a number of source controls for $249. Well, thank you very much for joining this session. Want to make sure we kept it on time. So just on time, we finished. So if you have any, need more information, please visit our website or write to our account, sales@nowtoolbox. Write to support, there's free unlimited support on the email. Q&A, any questions? I'm happy to answer anything you may have of questions. Some question could be, for example, what version we support. I don't think I actually added that here. We support from 2015 until BC 14 for the source control. Where for other Object Analyzer features, we support all the way back from version 4 actually, or 3.7 actually. And again, repeat, everything is running on Microsoft Azure. So fully cloud hosted, access from anywhere at any time. Thank you very much for your time today. I hope you enjoyed the presentation and see you back on nowtoolbox.com.